is going to end up happening as Camille is going to be locked in last.
This was one of the classic.
That's a pivot, Jarvan, and this is sort of what I was meaning. The Sin.
Oh, well, there's multiple flashes. It's going to work this time. Yeah, exactly. Literally looks for a steal on this Mountain Drake. Guga gets the inside track as well as Kuzan moves on over. And this is just dynamics walking in and taking
up in this wave and then look to get a recall off. So, Hextech ultimatum. Yep.
Yeah, Rich going to take a lot of damage here. No flash, remember. So, Kakao flash through 5v5. Ocean Drake going down very, very low. Package just delivered over here as they are able to secure it.
Yeah, but things are definitely going to be a little bit rough. Hextech ultimatum.
Underneath the turret here as well as Kuzan's going to get knocked up. The taunt flashed away from there by Kuzan, but the Colossal Smash comes in and puts the Corki in the Death Chamber. That was well forced on the side of Cerebral Gaming, but they are able to come out on top as Danchunk does get stunned. There's the Cataclysm over the wall. As Cosmic Radiance does come down, Danchunk, good double two-man taunt as Nova just uses his Showstopper very interestingly there, and it is just going to be answered by Team Dynamics. Nova now finds himself on the wrong side of everything.
Oh,
not going to get knocked up, but FaZe just flashing on forward. The Haymaker doesn't get anything done, and I don't know why FaZe decided to flash, but he's still able to get the kill. So weird that people don't understand how to pronounce Corseted that well. As Sungyun's going to fail the flash. He failed one in the last series. He wants to do it again as he's now stuck in that Cataclysm. Moonlight Vigil comes down. FaZe just likes pressing buttons, guys. As this also feels right. Team Dynamics just going to steal away yet another dragon. Nova also getting full comboed by Rich. He's going to die for free. In fact, Guga picks up that kill, and now Cataclysm has been channeled. It's only a one-man taunt from Danchunk who's just going to get taken down. FaZe
is
going to be worth 2.5 minutes on the Cloud Soul. It doesn't matter. Look at the damage out of this Aphelios.
He's in Antarctica right now.
That was definitely not 200 years.
That was not 200 years.
That was barely 200 milliseconds that that Baron went down.
Well, the item won't really change Galio all that much. So,
Beyond is just going to get murdered. So Tal now looking to try and deal with Kuzan. There's the flash from Kakao though, gets the knock up, but I don't know whether he wins that 1v1 as Rich is going to be able to take down Tal. There's the Cosmic Radiance. Now Danchunk finds himself in the middle of the members of Team Dynamics. Moonlight Vigil comes down as well. Nova going to get slowed. Rich is going to be there to answer as it's a double kill in for the Aphelios, and Dynamics turn it all around. That was their jungler being caught, and they turn it into 4 kills.
They turned it into 4 kills, and Beyond didn't even have to blow his flash or anything, so he's going to be able to keep that. They're going to raise the mid-tier 2 turret, and they should immediately turn right back around and head towards the Cloud Soul.
I think that maybe Cerebral Gaming should probably ban one of the 2 champions that he can play, but here's another team fight. Infernal Chains is going to land. There's the World Ender once again for Rich as the Showstopper gets into the backside, but Nova is just going to die. Cloud Soul comes in as we talk about it. Bullet Time does basically nothing as it's a double kill. Aatrox does fall down, but now Beyond's looking for the knockup, gets it onto Sungyun in the backline. A triple kill for Kuzan as Kakao and Danchunk just escape. They run for the hills. And now with Baron still running for another second, they move this minion wave towards the inner turret and use their Cloud Soul to help take that one down. Really nicely done from Dynamics, and they are just smashing these team fights every single time.
And it's looking like they're gonna raise the inhibitor turret. Now, I think backing off would be more ideal, but it looks like they wanna actually raise the inhibitor.
I actually don't mind this because there's an outer turret still up top lane. He's picked up the rapid fire cannon. Danchunk's dead as we get back into live. I don't know. He was, I guess, looking for a different place to perch, and that wasn't the one that he wanted. Is now Rich up against 3 people. We'll see what he can do with it. Able to turn that one around. He's still sitting at half health. There are not enough forbidden books here to try and stop this, as now Nova gets the superplex, but he dies in midair. Team Dynamics have full control of this game. And we were talking about this as being Cerebral's game to lose, right? Because the split push was going to be impossible to stop. Tal's been trying to team fight. It's just, it's mismanagement of what this composition is supposed to do, right?
So the really weird thing was in the early to mid transition, Cerebral was actively trying to make plays and try to get even further ahead, and that was just completely unnecessary. We're going to have one last Hail Mary.
Yeah, the Flaking Teleport from Tal. Rich is here with him, though. As Beyond, he's down to half health. Oh, interrupted on the hook shot, but still the heroic entrance comes down. Tile goes golden, answered by the Cosmic Radiance. Tile's gonna get stunned. The Aphelios picks up the first kill. Nova gonna go down as well. Kuzan grabs that. Tile now trying to run away. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the end of the game. Kuzan's going to chase after, try and get another one. Rich picks up the kill onto Sangyun. There is only Kakao alive. And Team Dynamics will win game number one in pretty fast fashion. Honestly, this felt like just another day in the office for this team, despite the fact that Cerebol did have, in the draft, a clear way of winning. It didn't matter. 9,000 gold to the lead at the end. 26 minutes after a 20-minute Baron was taken down. That is not what Nautilus does at all, as Guga is going to lock away the set. Somehow, set falls to the final pick on red side.
Lost his blue buff, finds himself up a camp, up CS as okay.
Yeah, Tal looking for Rich here. Great knock up. Death's Grasp brings Rich all the way back in. No way that he can do anything as Kakao.
Hopefully, yep, as Dynamics.
Ocean Drake does come up very easily. He went back to base as now it's Durable starting off this Cloud Drake.
They rotated five members over. Wait.
Oh, Dan Chung just gets engaged on Guga, makes his way into the pit. Emperor's Divide is huge, but the Azir is just dead. Two kills already for Team Dynamics, whose team fights have been just so damn good. Tal now running away, and everyone is here on Dynamics' side as Kuzan gets over, steals Tal's flash, and Guga comes in with the Facebreaker. The Brambleback getting involved as well, as that is not enough shielding, and Guga's going to lock down that kill. Sangyun, no matter.
Right now, Dynamics, I mean, they're sitting really comfortable here.
I'm feeling they're not going to be able to do enough as five members of Dynamics are in the area. Beyond gets the turnaround ultimate. There's the Showstopper into the back line. Emperor's Divide does absolutely nothing as Rich is on top of Dan Chung and will put him in the death chamber. Kakao now out of this fight for good as Rich gets in on top of Sangyun. The Death Realm is in, and it's Rich fighting against Tal, and now Tal is going to be too far up in this lane. Gonna get stunned up, the Facebreaker comes in, Guga even grabs the kill, as Trouble Bubble just barely misses onto Sangyun. And Dynamics, they move into this mid lane, they take down the outer turret, they should be able to get work done on this inner, and Shirley is gonna have a really good time here, as Rich just showing off some adorable bees, as he has Death Dance as well, so that's going to help.
It's all about Zoe here, and what she can do.
Oh, well, there's the Showstopper into the back line. Guga maybe going a little bit too early, but the Haymaker keeps him alive. Dan Chung picks up that first kill, but now he's taken down very low. Rich once again with a fantastic team fight. Kakao, Permafrost taken down. Tal's gonna die just off the back end. And
Zoe had a good performance. Also has been playing a lot of different champions so far.
Rich knew that and decided that, much like an Animal Crossing, when you want to dress up, he wanted to dress up as Aatrox. So.
Yeah.
Really appreciate if you could just recognize him for the fashionista that he is.
Well, Baron taking it 20 minutes. Renan's Hurricane already completed by FaZe. Hasn't done a lot of damage this game, but hasn't really had an opportunity to because the Limelight has been stolen. To cleanse to avoid that Trouble Bubble. And the Banshee's Veil is what he's going to get for his trouble. This inhibitor going to be taken down. 40 seconds until that Infernal Soul is going to be there. We'll see where the Dynamics move back to collect that one. The last ditch teamfight is going to be happening now as Tal has teleported behind Dynamics, but there's a control ward there. He's just been met as he throws down the Death Realm. Now the rest of Dynamics are going to have to try and see what they can do. Beyond is there in the Death Realm with him, but look at the damage. The Showstopper gets Guga into the backline. Three-man Facebreaker. Immediate double kill from FaZe, as this will just be the end of the game. Kuzan flashing forward. Dan Chung down very low as he has to sit on his fountain.
That's
now.
It.
And Dynamics speedrunning the promotion tournament. This is likely a 24-minute victory, maybe not even that, as the next Nexus turret is going to go down. Rich flashing on top of Sungyun, has to flash to his fountain. And Dan Chung is now in the trouble bubble. 23 and a half minutes for game two, 26 minutes for game one. This is one of the fastest promotions that we've seen.